Support for this project was provided by Garnica Plywood. Challenge the ordinary with the finest plywood for the most demanding clients. Rockler Woodworking and Hardware. Create with confidence. And Bedmasters, making custom-made affordable mattresses in the United States for over 22 years. Learn more about these project sponsors by clicking on the links in the description. All right, well, this was definitely one of my bigger projects, so I'm really going to take my time with it. We'll go over all the parts step by step. I'll have detailed plans and a cut list that you can find on my website. And if you want to use the same mattress that I use, I'll have a link in the description to the mattress that Bedmasters built for me. Let's go ahead and get started. The first step is breaking down the full sheets of plywood. The project starts by making two cabinets. The cabinets consist of a top, bottom, and what I'm calling dividers. The dividers are made by laminating two pieces of 3/4-inch plywood together. When I'm breaking down full sheets like this, I like to cut everything a little bit heavy, and then I can come back and cut the material to the exact size when it's a little bit smaller, lighter, and easier to handle. The top and bottoms of the cabinet are too big to fit into my crosscut sled, so I'm using a straight line rip jig and my circular saw. For the dividers, I like to crosscut the material a little heavy first using my miter saw, and then set up a stop block on the crosscut sled and cut all the parts to length. For the two cabinets, I used 4 sheets of 3/4-inch birch plywood, and I have a diagram in the plans that explains the best way to cut the material out of each sheet. So if you're going to build this project, definitely check that out. So you can see that I've already built one of the cabinets. I'm going to take this off the table. And when I build the next one, I'll go over all the details. I've already figured out the math on the width of my drawers. I want all of my drawers the same. And then I cut a stick at that measurement, which is 25 5/16. And I use that stick to mark out where the dividers will go. With the bottom of the cabinet marked, I'll transfer those lines to the top. Then I'll open up the top and bottom of the cabinet like a book, and I'll transfer the lines from the back out to the front. Now I'm marking lines to drill holes through the inside of the cabinet. I'm not going to countersink these holes, because I'll be drilling through the plywood, and once I flip it over, then I'll countersink on the outside of the cabinet. I just finished countersinking the holes, and now I'm going to flip it over, and I'll start to position the drawer dividers and the sides. Before I assemble the cabinet, I want to talk a little bit about the sides and the dividers. They're both made by laminating 3/4-inch plywood together. The dividers are exactly 30 inches long. The sides are made with a 30-inch long piece on the inside and a 30 1/4-inch long piece on the outside, and that's to accommodate a 1/4-inch plywood back. Thank you. Okay, well, I finished building both cabinets yesterday, and I just got back from the lumber yard where I was buying 1x6 S4S poplar. S4S stands for surfaced on four sides. It's really easy to work with because it's already milled for you. The next step is to rip the poplar down to 1.5-inch strips, and I'll use those strips to trim out the front of the cabinet, and that will hide the edge of the plywood. When I ripped the poplar down to 1.5 inches for the front of the cabinet, I also ripped a few pieces of 3/4-inch plywood that I'm using as filler material. This piece measures 1 inch and it will be attached to the bottom of the cabinet, and it will provide a nailer for the face frame molding at the bottom. Here I'm using a few bandy clamps from Rockler to help attach the face frame to the cabinet. Now I've got the cabinet upside down and I'm attaching 3/4-inch filler strips to the bottom of the top. And they're there to prevent the drawer from tipping down as you pull it out of the cabinet. I'm attaching the filler strips with wood glue and 1¼-inch nails. After I finished up with the cabinets, I moved on to making the parts for the base. The bed is going to rest on a 3-inch high base, and I got started by ripping 3/4-inch birch plywood down to 3 inches for the bracing, and then on the outside of the base will be a piece of 3/4-inch poplar. And then on the very outside, I've resawed a piece of 3/4-inch walnut down to 1/4 inch. So now that I've got all the parts, I'm gonna go ahead and put it together. To get started building the base, I'm marking out where each brace will go, and then I'll transfer those lines . Then I'll drill the holes about 3/8 inch away from the line that would split the 3/4-inch brace. I'm not countersinking on the inside. Now I'll flip the board over and countersink the hole. To build the base, I'm going to tack the parts together with 1½-inch nail. And that'll keep them from moving around when I'm screwing the parts together. So I'll just make sure I'm nice and flush. And next I'll use 1⅝-inch screw. All right, well, I've finished with the base, and the next step is to get to work on the drawers. I'm making the drawers out of 3/4 inch birch plywood, and the first step is to rip everything to width. I'm going to rip everything a little bit heavy, and then I'll come back and make a cleaner cut when the material is lighter and easier to handle. When I'm cutting the parts for the drawers to length, I like to cut them a little heavy first using the miter saw, and then set up the crosscut sled on the table saw, and then set up a stop block and cut everything to length. I made this crosscut sled a few months ago, and it's just been a huge time saver and just really valuable for this project and other projects. If you want to build it, I will have a link in the description. Okay, so now I've got all of my parts to the drawers cut, and this is one of those things that can be a little confusing, so definitely just take your time, and as the old saying goes, measure twice, cut once. I've got my drawer sides laid out here, my drawer fronts, and the backs I'll cut later. I also have some scrap wood, and I'll be making the same cuts in the scrap wood as I do in the drawers, and that way I can test my fit on the scrap wood first before I make the cuts in the drawers that I'll be using, or the material that I'll be using. So the first step is to raise the blade up 1/4 inch and then set the fence at 3/8 inch. I'll first make a pass on the scrap wood and then on the parts that I'm using for the drawers. Now that I've got a groove cut in my test piece and all of my parts, I've moved the fence over a little bit more than 1/16 inch. I'll take another pass and I'll test it on the 1/4 inch plywood that I'm using for the drawer bottom. And once I have a snug fit on the test piece, I'll run all the parts through the saw. Okay, so I got lucky on the first pass. That's a nice fit. You don't want it too snug because you don't want it to be difficult to put the drawer together, but at the same time, you don't want it real sloppy. That's why I make a test piece. Since this works good, now I'll run the rest of the material through the saw. The next step is to cut a 3/4 inch dado for the backs of the drawers. I'll make one pass with a standard size blade on the test piece, and then one pass on each side. Okay, so I've got a nice fit with the dado. I'd set the fence, and next I'll make this cut, the outside cut, on all the sides. And once I've made the outside cut on all the sides, I'll remove the rest of the material. The next step is to cut the back of the drawer to its finished width. And to get that measurement, you'll measure from the top of the drawer to where the groove for the bottom of the drawer begins. And in this case, it's 9 1/16, a little heavy. With all the parts cut, I was able to start building drawers. So let me show you how I put one together. I'm using 1 5/8 trim screws to build the drawers, so the first step is to measure and mark where I'll need to pre-drill holes. I'm drawing a line 3/8 from the front of the drawer and I'm splitting the dado in the back. Next, I'll measure down from the top of the drawer and mark 1.5 inches, 4, 6, and 8. And I'll do the same thing at the front of the drawer. 1.5, 4, 6, and 8. Then I'll drill a hole at those marks, not a countersink, just a hole. First, I'll attach the side of the drawer to the front of the drawer. I'll hold the parts flush and tack it in place with 1.5 inch nail. The 3.5 inch nails will help keep everything in line while I attach the side of the drawer to the front of the drawer with 1.625 inch trim screws. Next, I'll add a little glue in the dado and then drop in the back. Here, I won't need the 1.5 inch nails because the dado will hold it in place. And then I'll do the same steps for the other side of the drawer. Now I'll stand the drawer up on its front, add a bead of wood glue on the front groove towards the bottom, and then I'll drop the bottom of the drawer in the groove. Then I'll use a pencil and draw a straight line from dado to dado. Then shoot 1.25 inch nail about every 2 or 3 inches. And then for a little extra strength, I like to add a bead of hot glue at the bottom of the drawer and at the back. With the drawers finished, I'll move on to making the drawer fronts and use iron-on edge banding to finish the edge of the plywood. Now I'm ready to attach the drawer fronts to the drawers, and when I'm working with multiple drawers like this, I like to make a jig out of 1/4 inch plywood, so I only have to measure once. Now I can reach into the drawer with my drill and countersink the hole. To make sure I have the same 1/2 inch reveal at the top of each drawer, I'm going to clamp a piece of 1/2 inch scrap wood and make sure it's flush with the top of the drawer. Then I'll rest the drawer front on the 1/2 inch scrap wood. Make sure I have the correct reveal on the side of the drawer. Clamp it in place. And attach the drawer front with 4 1.25 inch screws. With the 2 cabinets and the drawers complete, it's time for finish. I'm using a water-based poly on the insides of the drawers and a semi-gloss latex enamel paint on the cabinet. The color is White Dove. I'll get a few coats of paint and finish on everything so I can move them out of the shop and make room to build the headboard and the footboard. Yesterday, I cut all of the parts for the footboard and the headboard, and then I put the footboard together and made the flat panel out of half-inch MDF, and then I played around with molding to come up with a molding design, and I'm really happy with the way it's gonna look. I'm looking forward to that part of the project. But before I do that, I have to make the headboard, which is a little bit more complicated because you have kind of this zigzag thing happening here where the bottom of the headboard is flush with the front of the leg and the top of the headboard is flush with the back of the leg. So you have this kind of a little thing like this happening here. And it will all make sense once I start building it. So we're gonna go ahead and build the headboard using pocket screws, and then we'll make a flat panel at the top using the half inch MDF, and then we'll get to trim it out. Now I'm going to attach the 3/4 inch return to the top of the bottom part of the headboard. And I'm using wood glue and a few 1.5-inch nails. I'm going to countersink a few holes in this filler strip. So I can tie the filler strip to the top of the headboard. Now I've got the headboard put together, and the next step is to make the flat panel at the top of the headboard. For that, I'm using 1/2-inch MDF that I ripped to 4 inches. And I want the flat panel to start 11 inches from the platform at the bottom. So I've cut a piece of scrap wood at 11 inches. I'll hold it on the platform, mark lines, and then I'll attach the MDF at those lines with a little glue and 1-inch nails. Now I'm ripping 2 pieces of poplar at 1.75 inches. This molding will go on top of the footboard and the headboard. I'm using a molding cutter and the table saw to make bead molding for the inside of the flat panels. If you don't have a molding cutter and you can't find bead molding, 3/8 quarter round would also look nice. At the bottom of the headboard and footboard where I'm using the bead molding, again, if you can't make or find bead molding, you could just use a piece of 5/16 by 3/4 inch stock, maybe round it off a little bit with sandpaper, and that would also look good.
I'm using the router to put a slight round over at the top of the footboard and the headboard, and I think that will give the bed a nice modern look. Now I'm making molding for the top of the bed, and I'll start by ripping walnut at 1¼ inches. Then I'll use the router to put a slight round over on one side of the molding. Then back at the table saw, I'll set the angle of the blade at 12 degrees and adjust the fence so the blade will cut at the point of where the round over begins. With all the walnut accent pieces made and sanded, it's time for finish, and I'm using 4 coats of Waterlox wipe-on varnish. To assemble the bed, I'll attach the cabinets to the base using 2-inch screws. Next, I'll attach the headboard and the footboard with 3-inch deck screws into the leg of the headboard and footboard, and 2-inch screws into the plywood backing of the headboard and footboard.
Well, I couldn't be happier with the way this turned out. I think it looks great. My wife loves it. And it's definitely a big inspiration to make more furniture for the room. And I've got some ideas for some artwork for the room. And I'm just really, really happy with the whole thing. And I want to thank my sponsors because they made this whole project possible. This project took about 3 weeks to build and video and edit. And so a big thank you to Rockler Woodworking and Hardware. Check out rockler.com for all your woodworking needs. And Garnica Plywood. I can't say enough about Garnica Plywood. It's just such a pleasure to work with. I get Garnica Plywood from Blaisdell Architectural Supply here in New Jersey. You can contact Fessenden Hall. They're the distributor of Garnica Plywood in New Jersey. Or you could just ask wherever you buy plywood if they sell or if they will sell Garnica Plywood, because I tell you, once you use it, I know you're going to like it. It's just a great product. And a huge thank you to Bedmasters. I'm really impressed with that bed. It's such a comfortable bed. I slept in it last night. And I'm just really impressed with the quality of it. And it's kind of amazing how this really thick, beautiful mattress can come out of that box. It kind of blows my mind. And if you want to see exactly how my mattress was made and how it was packed up, I'll have a link in the description, and that will take you to a video on the back end of my channel, and you can see the whole process. It's really pretty cool. So, and I also want to thank you guys, because you really are a huge motivator for me to make these long format videos. I know it definitely goes against the grain of being a successful YouTube channel to make a 30-minute long video. But with a project like this, I'm really trying to put all the information that I think you're going to need to make this project. So along with the plans and the cut list, this video and some other videos that I'll have in the playlist, my hope is that you'll be able to build this project and you'll be really happy and proud of the project that you build. So again, I really appreciate all your positive feedback and the thumbs up. And I guess that's it. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you soon.
For a behind-the-scenes look at projects and in-depth Q&As, check out my Patreon page. To keep up with projects on a daily basis, follow me on Instagram and Facebook.